Hey kids, welcome back to another exciting week of Kids Points. I sure do miss you guys and can't wait to see you again soon. Last week, we heard an amazing story from the Bible, and today's story is even better as we get to learn about how God sent his one and only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins. Spoiler alert, he comes back on the third day. So let's go ahead and jump in.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Watson here, but you can call me the Easter Bunny. Get it? Because I'm a bunny and it's Easter. You get an egg and you get an egg. We got eggs for everybody. Wait, I'm sorry, what's that? We don't have eggs. No eggs to give out. Okay, no problem. You set them on a video screen right now, like this is on a video. Okay, perfect, check this out. I can have my boy Doug put some eggs into the video. Digital eggs. Go, Doug! Oh, those eggs were egg-tacular. And we're back. Like I was saying, I will be your host for today. And we are gonna have so much fun that I can't hardly contain it! But I can. And I have to. Gotta keep it together. So, we're gonna kick things off by singing and dancing a little bit. You like to sing? You like to dance? Well, good! You're in luck, because we're doing both of those things in that order. So stand up on your feet, and I'll go start the music! Hold on, give me a second. Sorry, things not working. There we go.
Oh,
my goodness, you guys sound so good, especially that guy over there. Yeah, you know who you are. I'm gonna call you Mr. Dancy Pants. Anywhom, today is an extra special day because it's Easter, the day the Easter Bunny was born. That's why we're celebrating today, and that's what we're gonna be talking about all day. I'm super excited, and I'm certain that you will learn a lot.
Hold on a second. Did you just say that Easter was about celebrating the birth of the Easter Bunny?
Oh, hey, Pastor Cameron, what's up? Yes, I sure did, and I can't wait to talk about it. I've been celebrating it my whole life.
I don't exactly know how to tell you this, Watson, but that's not what Easter's about.
I'm pretty sure that it is, but hey, it's okay to be wrong, pal. Happens to the best of us. But I will say, this is pretty embarrassing for you. Got a little egg on your face there. Get it? Because Easter. You don't even know why we celebrate Easter?
I'm not embarrassed, and I definitely do know why we celebrate Easter. We're celebrating Jesus, who was raised back to life.
Wait. What?
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 What are you? What?
What?
You're telling me that somebody was dead and they came back to life?
Well, not just anybody, the savior of the world, Jesus. That's who we're talking about today.
Okay, hold on, wait a second. If Easter is about Jesus, then what holiday is it that we celebrate the birth of the Easter Bunny? You know, we give gifts, we hang stockings, we put up a tree.
I think you're thinking of Christmas, and again, that's also about Jesus, not about the Easter Bunny.
Huh, well, agree to disagree, I guess, but hey, tell me more about this Jesus.
Oh, I will. That's actually what we're talking about all day today. We're talking about how Jesus was raised back to life, and because of that, we can have a new life with him. He makes us new. That's why today we are saying, every day, I am who Jesus says I am. But like I said before, we're going to take some time right now and talk more about the real story of Easter with our Bible story today. Let's check it out.
The story of Easter. Jesus's sacrifice. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
The Jewish leaders and teachers did not like what Jesus was doing or how he claimed to be the Son of God. And so they made a plan to arrest him to get rid of him once and for all. Judas, one of Jesus' disciples, agreed to betray Jesus.
Come in.
And give him over to the religious leaders for some money. Jesus was in a garden praying, and Judas showed the man who Jesus was. Jesus was arrested and taken to the rulers of the land so that they could decide what to do with him. Jesus was presented before the high council, and they asked him if he was the Messiah, the Savior of the Jews. They asked him if he was claiming to be the Son of God. You say that I am. And the council was furious, and they shouted that Jesus was guilty and he deserves to die. So they took Jesus before the Roman ruler Pilate, and he heard the case against Jesus. Pilate didn't think that Jesus had done anything wrong.
Seemed okay to me.
They found him to be innocent, so Pilate said that he would punish Jesus and then release him.
What?
But the crowd kept screaming louder and louder, "Crucify him! We want him dead!" And because of the pressure of the crowd, Pilate turned Jesus over to the Roman soldiers to be crucified. Jesus was hurt and spit on, his clothes were torn and taken from him, and a crown made out of thorns was put on his head. He was beaten so badly that he could barely stand on his own. And then he was forced to carry his cross so far up a mountain that he needed help because he could not do it on his own. Then Once Jesus made it to the place where he would be crucified, called the Skull, the soldiers around him nailed him to the cross and waited for him to die. While Jesus was hanging on the cross, many people shouted to him, "If you really are the Son of God, save yourself from the cross." But Jesus knew he had to die to forgive his people for their sins. At noon, darkness fell across the whole land. 3 hours later, Jesus took his last breath and finally died. At that very moment, the curtain in the temple that separated the priests from God's holy place tore in two. A soldier watching the whole thing said, "This man truly was the Son of God." Then a righteous man named Joseph came and placed Jesus' body in a tomb. 3 days passed, and it seemed that there was no hope. But very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body and found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there. "Don't be afraid," said an angel. "He is not here. He is risen." At this, the woman remembered that Jesus had told them that he would rise again on the third day.
Woo-hoo!
And ran to go tell the disciples what they had seen and heard.
Huh?
Hey-o!
Ah!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life.
So what do you think about that? I know, buddy. It's pretty incredible. And we're gonna take some more time and talk about what the resurrection means for us. But for now, I'm gonna make sure Watson's okay.
The resurrection of Jesus. The day Jesus was raised back to life. It's the greatest day in history. But for us to see why this is so amazing, we first have to go back to see all the hurt and loss that came before it. God created the world. He made the sky, the waters, and the land. He made the sun, moon, and stars. He made the fish, the birds, and the animals, and everything that God made was good. And then he made man, the first human, Adam, and he was very good. But God did something special for the man. God breathed into the man. His breath, his life entered into the man, and the man began to live. The man was put in charge of the world, and everything was as it was supposed to be. The man and his wife were to spend their days taking care of the paradise that God created for them, while loving and closely knowing their God. But it wasn't enough for us to know God, to love God, just to be with God. We wanted to be God. We wanted us to be in charge, not God. This is what we call sin. In that paradise, we turned our back on God, choosing to go our own way instead of God's way. Sin entered deep within us, taking the place of God's breath and life. Now, we were filled with darkness and sin. This same darkness of sin covered the whole earth. Now, we were separated from the God that made us and loved us in a world of darkness of our own doing. Years went by and more people were on the earth. Yet, we were all still the same, full of darkness and sin, fighting to put ourselves over others and God. And now, we have the world we live in today. And although at times it can seem like everything is fine, like everything is going our way, there is still a deep separation of us and our world from the God that loves us. Knowing that it was hopeless for his people to ever rid themselves of this darkness, God took it upon himself to come into the world he created to rescue the people he still loves so much. God became a man, Jesus. He was born into the world like us, but grew up without ever giving in to sin. He was the bright light of God in a world of darkness. He loved people. He cared for people. He helped people everywhere he went, but he was on a mission. His mission led him into the hands of dark-hearted men who nailed Jesus to a cross. On that cross, he took the sin and darkness of the world on himself, and he died. His body was placed in a tomb, and there all thought the light of the world would stay dead forever. But then, after 3 days, the life and the breath of God re-entered his body, and Jesus rose from that grave. He came back to life. He defeated sin and death and darkness. It's the greatest day in history. And now he offers his life and his light to all who love him and follow him. When you choose to follow Jesus, he breathes his life into you and you become alive on the inside. His spirit comes to live on the inside of you so that you can know him and love him and be with him right now. But his resurrection also points to the future, to the next greatest day, to the day when his resurrection power will pour life back over all of the earth, when all darkness will be removed and even our own bodies will be changed like his, so that we can be with him forever with nothing in between us. The day when Jesus will make all things new. This is the day that we're looking forward to. If you've chosen to follow Jesus, you're already new on the inside. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away, and look, new things have come." Jesus makes you new on the inside when you choose to follow him, but there is a day coming when our body, our minds, and all of creation around us will be made new too. The resurrection power of Jesus that changed the inside of you will one day change everything around you. This is the great hope and joy for all of us that love and follow Jesus. Maybe you're living in an unfair situation. Maybe you feel alone, like no one really cares for you. Maybe you don't really fit in. Maybe it's difficult for you to find friends. Maybe you don't have what you need. I'm not talking about the latest shoes or games, but the basics like food or clothes. Maybe you lost someone you loved, and it still hurts. Maybe your family is broken, or you don't really have a family at all. Maybe you've been hurt or mistreated, lost or forgotten. Here's the good news. One day Jesus will make all things new. Every wrong he will make right. Every bad will be removed. And our new life will be in a perfect new world. One without pain, without hurt, without loss, without sadness. Instead, we will have Jesus with nothing getting in the way. So what do we do now? We hold on to the guarantee of our future life and world. This guarantee is the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God that lives in us who follow Jesus. 2 Corinthians 1:22 says he set his seal of ownership on us, and he put his spirit in our hearts as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. When you're born again, when you choose to follow Jesus, God sends his spirit to live on the inside of you. This is the same spirit that was in Jesus, who raised Jesus from the dead. When he comes in you, he changes you and makes you new on the inside. The Holy Spirit in you is God's proof of the life and the world to come. It's kind of like this. Have you ever ordered something online? You know, the moment that you pay for something online, that item is yours. The place that you're buying from will usually send you an email guaranteeing you that your item is on its way. Now, it may take a few days to get here, but you don't panic. You have the proof that it's already paid for and it's on its way. But this email guarantee isn't very exciting, is it? All you can do is look at it every once in a while, and that's basically it. But our guarantee, the Holy Spirit, is way different. He changes us right now. He makes us new and allows us to be with God right now in this life. The good news is Jesus is the one that's already paid for your new life through his cross and resurrection. He's paid the price for you. And when you accept that, he sends his Holy Spirit to live in you and change you. The Holy Spirit is like your guarantee that you're going to be fully changed one day in his new creation. Isn't that good news? The resurrection allows you to have life on the inside today and a guarantee of your new life with him in the future, forever with the God that loves you.
Whoa, what an amazing day! Hey, I'm so glad you got to join us for it. There's so much I didn't know about Easter, with the Jesus, and the dying, and the 3 days, and the raising back to life, and the new life for us. This holiday is so much better than I thought it was. And hey, I hope you learned as much as I did. Everybody, say this after me one more time. Say, every day, I am who Jesus says I am. Awesome. Hey, that's it for this week. We'll see you next time.
What a wonderful thing that someone would love us so much that they would give up their own life so that we could live. I'm thankful to have Jesus as my personal Savior, and I pray that one day he's yours too. This week, I want to challenge you to be extra loving to the people in your house. Don't use unkind words. Obey your grown-ups. Do something nice for them for no reason. I can't wait to see you next week.